Hello and welcome back to Factorio. So I now have two trains running to the Iron Outpost, and I have redesigned my output. I saw someone saying and pointing out that you don't need more than four things. I've upgraded this to steel chests because, seeing as I don't need as many, I can use the one with the higher capacity. But if you have four steel chests per car, outputting in this way and then splitting off into a single thing, that is enough to keep actually a single blue belt completely full. So you can definitely fill red belts. So I now have, if I go to map mode, eight red belts running around here, up here, and then here I've got an 8-6 balancer. With that balancer there, I probably don't need this one here, but it doesn't hurt. So we are now outputting steel and iron a lot better than we were before. We seem to be doing okay on the copper. Green circuits are okay. We do have a problem in that we don't have any oil. As you can see there, no oil. And the reason why we have no oil is we are not getting enough petroleum. Nowhere near enough. So there's two things I want to do in this episode. One is I need to sort out this train track here. Do you see the way these are all blue? That's because these tracks are so close together that there's no way to separate them. So, you know, as I was saying earlier, I discovered the advantage of having them at a gap like this is that you can separate this line from this line when it comes to your junctions. So by, you see the way that these all went red? So like, even though this car was turning in there, for example, the building train wouldn't be able to turn and go in there because it would just, it would get blocked by the presence of a thing anywhere on this line. So I need to redesign this. And I was thinking about it, and the easiest, because I don't really have room now to add the second line spaced out, because it's going to cause issues here, where I can't make it lower because it's going to mess with this station, and I can't make it higher because it's going to mess with those stations. So my solution is I'm going to turn this into a one-way roundabout. I'm going to pick a single one of these tracks, let's say the outer one. So when the train is coming back from down there, it will have to take the long way round and do that. It is a slightly longer travel time, but in general, I don't think it's going to make that much difference. I mean, it's having to do that anyway. Going up, around, and then down is not going to be too bad. So, which one am I going to keep? Let's have a quick look at this and see if there's a choice. Well, this kind of makes my choice. I can get rid of that little squiggle if I keep the inner track. So the inner track is the one that goes in that direction. So a train coming up from here can head that way, but it can't head this way. So I can remove that. And I need to remove this. This is going to mess up the trains until I get this finished. Although if I do it right, they might always still be able to go around the other side. Alright, so that's the track I'm taking away. So, a train on the right-hand side can go that way. So this is going to be the direction of travel. So a train can come from that way and go down that way. That's actually all I need to do, I think. I am going to rethink the signals, because what you want is a proper signal if there's room for an entire train length in front. Otherwise, you want a chain signal. So I'm trying to picture this now. trains are going to come up from here. Is there room for an entire train length in front of this? Yes. Yes. And, well, there won't be there now. If I put this one here, and I'll make this a chain signal. Hmm. I thought I had my head wrapped around signals, but maybe I don't. Is this an entire train's length? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Not quite. So we're going to move this one out. So now there is room. Ah, it was meant to be a normal signal. Please be a normal signal. Right, so. Don't get run over. There can be a normal signal here because there is room for an entire train in front of it. There can be a normal signal here because there is room for an entire train in front of it. And there can be a normal signal there. I think I need a chain here. No, it doesn't like that, does it? Maybe this one does have to be here. That seems to work. Right, so I'm going to adjust this to be this insane giant roundabout, because I should have paid attention to all the people who always added gaps in between their train tracks. Right, so I think I've got this sorted out now. I fiddled with the signals a bit. Hopefully they work okay. I'm just checking the running of the coal train, because I've sort of seen all the others doing their job. I've seen the oil running and so on. I've not actually seen copper running, but it doesn't go into this sort of inner base bit anyway, so that should be okay. Hopefully this won't take too long to fill up. There we go. I'll just make sure this the coal can get back to the base. And then I think I might need to use less solid fuel, because that's probably where most of my petroleum is going. What I might do is tell it to only make solid fuel if I have spare petroleum. Yep, so this works okay. So I'm not loading my iron fast enough. Where is my iron mine? I think one of them just shot off, but there's another one. So this, I think, needs to be upgraded to red. That's why it's not loading fast enough, because I've only really got 4 lines coming in. So if I upgrade that to red, then I can, you know, then I can do that. So it's probably something I need to do. I need to sort out the plastic, though, because if we go to the map and come up here to where plastic's meant to be made... Oh, I'm sorry. I zoomed in far too much. There is still... You can see the petroleum strobing on and off. So let's see if I can safely make it across here. So what I want to do is... Here's the pump that's pumping my petroleum into the solid fuel. I need to program it to only do that if we have spare petroleum. So we can use the wire network, which has run down to here. So if I stick a big electric pole here, right, so it's within range of that one, and then there. So I should be at a red wire from there to there. And basically you can stretch a wire as long as the electric poles can go. So if I can get through here, and go to that one, and then to there. Right, so what was the programming I had on this? Because... Please put the wire away. Thank you. Right. Connected network. Enable if you've got more than a certain amount. So that's all that's in there, really. And we can read the amount of petroleum we've got. So I think if I've got more than 5,000 petroleum, this can turn on. If petroleum greater than 5,000, then you can turn on. Yep, okay, so connected to network, it knows how much petroleum I've got. But I'm still not making enough. It's not a lack of oil. It is just a lack of pure production. Okay. Not really left myself much room, have I? I think I need like a couple more machines. Not keeping up with demand. I mean, at least we are now making plastic again. So we're getting red circuits. Blue circuits are actually backed up. Probably because we're not doing any research at the moment. Right, how can I squeeze more in? I rotated you round. Right, so what if I told you that I was going to do that? Could I in any way connect this in a way that's not going to drive me insane? Probably not, to be honest with you. I kind of wish these tanks were further away. Yeah, let's do it. Okay, I'm going to relocate these tanks. So this was... I've got to keep this stuff running. Make sure I keep the stuff flowing. This is... These ones are going to be easier, I think, because of the way I positioned them. I'm going to put these tanks I'm going to squeeze these tanks in over here somewhere and make sure I hook up the red lines again. Then we're going to see if we can get a few more of these guys in. Okay, well I've managed to squeeze another two in, which is not many. So our light oil and heavy oil are standing steady at 10,000. We still do not actually have enough petroleum, but we should be making more than we were before, and we shouldn't be doing this unless we have spare. So obviously we could do more cracking, but I don't think the amount of heavy or light is actually increasing. Like, it's not building up, it's staying under the 10,000. So we actually have enough cracking. These things are kicking in as and when they're supposed to. What are you guys complaining about? Probably lack of power. Yeah, lack of power. That's not helping things. Right, but if we go looking at our plastic production... Okay, we've made enough now that it's starting to back up. And these things are outputting at a reasonable rate. Right, what were the other things I needed to fix? I needed to upgrade steel. I mean the iron outpost, didn't I? Right, so let's pop a train down. Hop on. And I want you to go... control click here, please. Because we're not getting enough iron, and it's because we're using yellow belts. So we need to run an upgrade. There we go. Right. I've only got 400 on me. This might be a good time to drop down our first building train station, to be honest with you. Let's see how we do. This thing is set to do yellows to reds. Nothing else here is going to get in the way. I am not standing in the middle of the train. I don't think we need the guns here anymore, do we? There's a lot of bullets, though. Let's reverse this so we can suck the bullets back into here. Like so. And we're going to... reverse this. Actually, I think I'm just going to do that. There we go. Alright, so I'm going to drain all the bullets from here and replace these gun turrets with something a little better. Let me whitelist this. Filter, military... gun turrets, blue-handled inserters, and we could do red belts and stuff. Oh no, because it's currently yellow belts, so okay. I thought maybe they were all red belts and I could just easily grab them using the filter, but I don't think that's going to work. Let's just do that, shall we? So if I do this... oh, actually, they're using yellow-handled inserters. Please grab those and yellow-handled inserters. I don't think that's going to affect anything else on the base. So I do just need the bullets to go away. Let's do this from map mode, because it means you can zoom around and stuff without... it doesn't matter how you're standing or walking. Let's get all of them. And these guys. Right. I'm going to replace them with lasers. And we're going to do an upgrade on all this. Let's sort of get everything inside a certain area. That way I upgrade a minimum of the gun turret belts. Am I going to try and do this? Okay, so I've got all the gun turrets down, but I am out of red belts. So this is when I think I want to get the building train out here. So what we need to do is work out where we want the building train station to be. Right, so that does that. Yeah, see, this is still sort of one of the not so good lines. So we want this train station to go down somewhere. It needs to be close to the base. I mean, for preference, it wants to be in the base. But there isn't really room. I think I'm going to put it here somewhere. So let's get our curve. We do that. Actually, let's do that, and then we'll get our building train blueprint, building outpost. Right, I can get this as close to this wall as I can. So let's do that. I'm actually going to get rid of that curve and extend it down a little bit. And hopefully I've got enough on me to complete the station. Five entities missing construction materials. Yes, I know. That's this stuff happening down there. Right. Station name. Where am I? I am at Iron Ore Mining 1? Question mark? Yes. I am at Iron Ore Mining 1. So this is going to be building train. Iron ore mining 1. Come out of map mode, thank you. Right, so this station should be on, you know, asking for things. Let's just get its exit quickly sorted. And I'm hoping we're going to see some of the magic of this. Right, so we're just going to like have a loop at the end. Get you there. Oh, well, I messed that up, didn't I? Right, it needs to line up with that upper one. Get you in there. Now line you up. Is that straight? Is that what I had before? I am uncertain. Right, signal there. We'll just put a signal here. Right, so now like we've got a little loop there, which we are going to defend and stuff. But make sure I'm not standing on the track. But hopefully, if I go train, building train, I'm gonna. Okay, building train, home base. You can have a wait condition at the home base of inactivity, and we'll set it to 30 seconds. You know, give the bots time to run around and do stuff. Basically, if nothing has loaded or unloaded in 30 seconds, that's when you can move on. And you're going to go to iron ore here with an inactivity count of, say, 10 seconds. And as you can see, it's already on the way. Now, I need stuff within the construction range of this. So it should unload stuff. You can see the filters are changing as and when it's doing stuff. It's gained robots, and it's leapt into action. Now, I should have checked before I actually called the train in. Can I get by here? We're going to move this wall so it's around the train station as well. I should have checked these constant combinators and made sure it was only asking for the stuff I really wanted here. Although I have set the defaults pretty intelligently, I think. So one thing this place wants is it doesn't need a lot of mining drills, but if the biters damage any of the stuff, you know, then I want them to do that. You see, it's actually picking up all the trash. And that trash will go back to the base and get pushed into my storage and recycled. So, are we within... Is the entire base within building construction? No, it's not. So I just need to give it some extra roboports. Trim you off, and I think I can get a roboport in here. Yep, there's one there, and I'll put one over here. That way the entire base should be within construction range. So this base has now been supplied with repair kits and construction robots. Any miners which finish will get automatically picked up, put in the trash, and the train will come along and take it back to the base. You can see there was inactivity. So because there is now stuff here in this trash again, theoretically the train should come back, even if it's got everything else it needs. So we are having trouble charging. That's because, yeah, we are massively overloaded. Right, so I need to protect this. Do I have any gates? I do. Go away, tree. If I move that signal, then I can put train gates there. I have to be careful because the building train might be on its way back. Okay, I'm going to finish defending this outpost. Just before I go, the building train is on its way back here. That actually did not take long at all. So we've got gates, we've got lasers, we've got walls, we've got a massive hole in the wall. Let's fix that in the strangest and ugliest way imaginable. And the building train is back. So we're actually going to hop on the building train and we'll ride it back to the base. If you notice that the logistics are also working here, so it's as well as supplying the stuff the base needs, it's also updating my stuff. Which means if I'm out at an outpost and I'm using up building materials, the building train will respond and come and give me new stuff. So I just want to check what's happening to the trash and set up recycling, because that's another way we can increase our efficiency. Let's leap out. See, we're getting a lot less solid fuel now because we're only making it when we have spare petroleum. But the trash car is now empty. I think we just put it all over there because those things are requesting wood. So that's building trains. So what sort of recycling do I need to do? Now, if you mouse over a storage chest, it doesn't, like this storage chest is empty, it doesn't show you what's in the storage chest, it shows you what's in the entire system. So for a start, we have lots of bullets. So where in the factory uses bullets for things? Well, we use bullets to make science, don't we? Military science is made with bullets. So, one thing we can do is find where we are doing that. I mean, we're putting bullets in here, aren't we? But that's just like a passive provider chest. I mean, we could wire this thing up to say stop making bullets if we've got so many in the system. But that's probably taking things a little too far. What we primarily want to do is here we are making our bullets. So we could recycle yellow bullets into one of these machines. So, request a chest. If there's any yellow bullets hanging around the base, and I really, you know, you may as well get all of them. And I'm going to put that as a blue inserter, so it sort of will pick them up. Actually, I'm going to make it a stack inserter. So, if there's stuff in this chest, like if I take the yellow bullets out of here, okay, or if I empty it so it starts manufacturing. See, that one only had a chance to swing once, whereas this one has filled it with like 7. So it's recycling. And we want to do a similar thing here. We don't want this thing really to be making the bullets. Where do those bullets end up? They do end up in a load of machines, don't they? What might be good is I need to do an experiment. If I have my stack inserter facing that way, let me give it a chest, a belt running that way. And I just want to put something in there for it to pick up. There you go, walls. Right, so they end up on the same side as this thing. So if I put a requester chest here, that's a provider. Requester chest with a stack inserter, and I output the red bullets here, they'll end up on this belt, and they'll get in the way of these machines' manufacture. So again, we'll be recycling rather than making more bullets. And I will set this to... they may as well all end up here as well. So am I... do I want bullets on me? No. Okay, so my bullets are currently set to 0. So I just would like to see the bullets end up over there. There we go. Bullets are starting to pile in. So if I clear this bullet belt a bit... see, this thing takes up most of it. So that's how you can do recycling. I'm going to do most of the recycling in between episodes. But you can see how you can start to get reasonable efficiencies. Ah! We do have a problem, though, because we are actually taking from here to there. That's not going to work, because it just means we're going to be building bullets here instead. I need to think of a solution to that. Is there like a priority system? Okay. Oh wow, we are so hurting for power. Let me turn this off for a second. That's not what I wanted to happen. So this is at the 2000. Ah! This thing has requests from buffer chests turned off. So if I turn this into a buffer chest... For a start, we don't need that many. But if I make you a buffer chest... Do I have a buffer chest on me? I think I've got one of everything. There we go. You're now a buffer chest. So the one up there won't take from there anymore. Right, I'm going to have to watch that. So, looking at the recording times, I think I've got on another episode done. We've upgraded our iron outpost. Ah, this is why we're so hurting on power. This row isn't getting any coal because of how I set this up. Right, let's do a split. Come this way. Split, and we want an input priority from the right, because if we have solid fuel, we want to use the solid fuel, but we have to keep coal running up to these things, because otherwise that's why the entire base was basically dying. There we go, still not good. We definitely need to think about sorting out power. If you notice, that outpost is closed, because it doesn't need anything. But if ever we needed to do anything at this outpost, we could just pop into map mode. Like, we've got a lot of yellow belts here now that aren't doing anything. So I can just go, please pick up this stuff. And the moment they hit that buffer chest, it'll call the building train. So once you've got this system set up, you can start doing stuff remotely without you having to head on out there in person. Which takes time. In fact, I can get rid of the bullets as well. Bring those bullets back to the base, and all the stuff that's in this random junk chest. And theoretically, the building train is on its way. Yep, there it comes. The robots do our bidding at range. Right, so what is the next real priority? It might be nuclear power. I thought that was the building train. Oh, it's here. Loading the stuff, and it will stay until there's inactivity, so once it finishes loading. Otherwise, this outpost is working quite nicely now. Our belts aren't completely balanced. We can recycle some more stuff from here, can't we? Like, we no longer need that. And I need to replace that one there. Oh, and there's some extra lasers in here we don't need anymore. Because we moved the outer wall. But we could probably do with an extra laser here. So I just pop it down in ghost mode and the robots do everything. Clever gal, that Catherine of Sky. Bye-bye.